Radiation comes in many forms. Radiation can be anything from microwaves to radio waves. It can be iPhones and stuff like that. That's a type of radiation. The radiation, when it comes to the nuclear business, is called ionizing radiation. Ionizing radiation comes from the fission of atoms. Atoms are typically in the periodic table, they are stable until they get to a certain atomic mass. When you look at the nucleus of an atom, there's positively charged things called protons and neutral things called neutrons. The neutrons and the protons work together in the nucleus to form the atom. When you get too many protons, as we get heavier and heavier and heavier elements, we get so many protons in the nucleus that they're trying to push each other apart, so it has to give off energy, and that makes it radioactive. When you split the uranium atom in half, you now create two what we call fission products. Those things can be highly radioactive. So it's coming from the core of the reactor, actually inside the fuel bundle itself. The fuel is in a ceramic pellet, which contains it, which is sealed inside a zircaloy metal rod, which is sealed. So none of the radioactivity, the fission products themselves, are meant to escape. In a nuclear power plant, the sort of pathways that you can release radioactivity into the environment would be through the air or through the water. These plants are typically designed to have no release. But under normal operating conditions over long periods of time, occasionally small things can form small cracks and tiny amounts of radioactivity can be released. The important thing to remember is that radioactivity can be measured in small quantities, so we can detect the releases almost instantaneously and we can monitor them and make sure that the releases to the environment stay well below regulatory limits and certainly in levels that are completely safe for the environment. None of this stuff exceeds any levels that might cause harm to anybody.